was it worth it? You know, I gotta say the price of these courses is not cheap. There's definitely an investment made into this, and so anybody heading into this should be ready for it. They should take it serious and be committed, and yeah, be sure that it's something that you want to do. Don't just throw your money around for, you know. Of course, I don't want to give you pointers on how to live your life, but there is some cost involved. Do you get value for the price you pay? I can't speak for all of the sailing schools. And I want to be 100% upfront. There were a few issues for me. And this doesn't reflect on the company that I used. It was just a pain in the ass anyway. So I did three courses all in 1 week, the ASA 101, 103, and 104 program. And I had a problem when I got my books, these books, right? And this one, there was supposed to be another one. So this is the 101, this is basically basic sailing, and then there is also the 103, which is the next step, and then the 104. I only got the 101 and 103. Sent a lot of emails back and forth with the company I used, GoBaja Sailing, and you know, I never got them. I never got the last book. Also, there was one other, which is my logbook. You know, you invest a lot of money into something and that is educational. You want to have all the materials right away so you can start studying. I sent emails, they replied, sent back and forth. And I have to believe that they were trying to get me the book, and I don't know what the problem was, but I didn't get the book until I arrived here and went to the office. And it's actually the thickest book to study and read, in my opinion, probably the most important one. It's the 104, which has all of the information in the previous, which you need to know, of course, and then more skills so that you can go and charter a boat and cruise. I arrived, they had a book for me, and I would say that the frustration for me is also that when I was at the airport flying here, I got an email direct from ASA, American Sailing Association, saying, sorry for the inconvenience, and that they'll send me the book. It will arrive on the 5th. Well, my course started on like the 4th or whatever. So anyway, I got the book when I arrived. I found other ways to study. So I tried to prepare, but that was a little bit frustrating, and it's difficult to put it behind me and ignore. And like I said, I don't blame GoBaja Sailing, but I will blame the American Sailing Association. You know, I was contacting GoBaja Sailing, and they were telling me that they were trying to get another book. I sent an email direct to American Sailing Association as well, explaining the situation. And I paid for a membership, so come on, ASA, you know, get your shit together. When people pay you for a course, give them the information. What the cost is to print something like this is nothing. If they say they don't get it, respond quickly and send it out to them so that they have the material they need. Pronto. That's professionalism. So, I will say, that's a big negative for me, and I don't know if anyone else has had this type of problem with the ASA, but that's my review of them so far. As far as the course material goes, The course material is great, I think. You know, like the books themselves had some like typos and weird things, a tight reach, right? I don't know what a tight reach is. It's a close reach. If you're a professional organization, have your wording correct in the books that you expect the students to know for the tests. It's easy enough to do an edit after people have used the book and then reprint it with the corrections. I know that creating a book like this takes time and effort, but make it right. And once it's made, you can edit it and have the next print run correct. So do it. How did I feel about learning from GoBaja Sailing and my instructor, Doug? I feel great. I feel amazing. I feel blessed. Doug, I would highly recommend. I would highly recommend him. And, you know, like anyone watching my channel or my who knows my background and my involvement with a lot of different organizations, you know, canoeing, kayaking. I did documentary Canoe Icon at the North. I spent time and made a documentary on a sprint canoe and interviewed all the Canadian sprint canoe and kayak athletes, Olympic athletes. You know, the sponsorship that I've received from some of the, you know, biggest names and brands in North America. What I can say is that I have some experience with them and the level of skill and ability. I've had a lot of contact with different outfitters, leaders in the outdoor, you know, skill development, adventure industry. And Doug is at the top of his game. I would highly recommend him. I can't even believe how well he presented the course material. Incredible. Like, out of five, five. No question. I'd give him six. Anyway, highly recommend him. The skill level is incredible. I'm going to include a link to his profile so that you can see who he is, and I would definitely use him for lessons or like piloting a boat or captaining a boat, you know, boat transportation or like really anything like that. If you're looking for somebody to help you in this type of industry, I would recommend him. I'm going to include his profile so you can get in contact with him. The cost value. Yeah, so I have a lot more to learn. These courses are set up to teach you the skills so that you can go out and charter a boat on your own. Do I have the skills? Yeah, I think I have the skills. I think that I need to practice a lot more. I think that at the beginning, being on my own or with someone else with similar experience, there would be mistakes made and there would be the, how do we do this again, you know, and talk it through or before getting started, review something. This is going to be a ongoing learning process. And I think that the course and Doug has given me all of the skills that I need that I can then review and build on. I think that sailing is going to be something similar to, yeah, like wilderness canoe camping or, you know, mountaineering or these outdoor skills that you can continually learn and build on the skills for a long, long time, which is fantastic. That's my plan. Would I come back to GoBaja Sailing? I love this area. I can't wait to get out there tonight and just be on the Malecon, go maybe have some tacos, cerveza, go find some mezcal, you know, see the nightlife tonight out there. Hopefully it's cloudy, overcast, maybe there'll be a bit of a sunset. This place is beautiful. This place is probably one of the most beautiful places I've seen on the planet. I love it. I wish I could spend more and more time here. Would I return to use GoBaja Sailing? I'm gonna need to see what other courses they offer and when I think would be a good time to fit it into my education, my strategy of learning. I think the next step for me is to go and practice. Just get on boats and go and practice, 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 and then do another course. The next step in this adventure, build on the education, you know. Would I need to? The certifications I don't think are important, so maybe I don't need to. Maybe these courses are the foundation that I need, and from here I can just get experience. So we'll see. Aside from the issues with the ASA and getting my book, this has been a great experience. You know, the other thing that I take away from this, and I need to say it because I don't know if they will watch this video, but the people that I shared the boat with, the crew, my crew, I am so lucky. I'm a person that doesn't, like, I like people, but I don't care for people. You know what I mean? Or I do care for people. Maybe I don't like them. I like these people. I am so lucky to be with this group, you know? Fantastic. We were so busy. We were tired. I think that's, if anything, I would say I'm sad to be leaving the boat, and I'm sad to not be spending more time with these people. They are all people that I would really like to get to know more. I hope that I see them again. Well, I will see them tonight, you know, but I hope I see them again. These are good people. So yeah, if you're watching, thanks. Like I said on the trip, thanks for being a part of this part of my life, and thanks for sharing this part of your life with me. It's been great. Anyway, I'm gonna get cleaned up and head out on the town.